Today's video is going to be breaking down the shotgun Y trips halfback weak formation in Madden NFL 16. For those of you guys that are new to our YouTube channel, I want to welcome you today. And you've come across really interesting content. And this is our Madden Ultimate Team free guide. And what you'll want to do is, if you're new, this is actually the fourth installment in this series. And so if you're new, you want to check out that description and you want to check out that playlist, and that's going to give you all the access to all of the other content that's in this series. Also, guys, as we're working through this, I want to remind you that it may benefit you at some point to take some notes and just kind of get a feel for what I'm saying in the video, just to kind of basically get an idea of what you want to look for in your playbook. So we're in Kansas City, and we just got done talking about the shotgun bunch formation. We spent an hour talking about it, and we could probably spend another hour talking even more about it. It's the primary formation in the offense. Now, what we're talking about now is a change-up formation, basically a formation that we can utilize to serve a different purpose, and that's the shotgun Y trips halfback weak. Now, what this is really designed to do is, when your opponent is frequently base aligning his defense, because if you guys remember from the previous video, one of the key ways to stop the shotgun bunch attack is to play cover two and to user control, or excuse me, to base align your defense. Now, if they're doing that, then what we like to do is go into this Y trips halfback weak. Now, there's several plays that I want to talk about, but we're going to try to keep it kind of friendly to the Madden Ultimate Team segment. A couple plays you might want to check out on your own is KC Dig, read option, halfback base and 56 trap, and KC sticking up. Those are some plays, and then corner strike, halfback slip screen. Those are all good plays. But what we're going to do is, we're going to be talking today about the plays stick, the play verticals, the play PA wide receiver in, and I believe we will have some time to maybe even talk about the inside zone. All right, so we're just going to show you. Actually, excuse me, your quick auto is a halfback mid draw. So this is a formation you're going to be audibling to. Now, what you're going to see here is that the shotgun bunch is our base set, right? So we're going to be normally coming out in this formation, normally. And the Y trips weak halfback, the shotgun Y trips halfback weak formation, you want to access that by moving, you hit your audible screen, of course, and then you want to slide that left D-pad to the left a couple clicks until you get to it. I think it's four, and then you can go into your plays. Now, the first play I want to go over is stick, because this is probably the least talked about play, but it actually has a lot of things that it does very well. So we're going to use stick basically like spacing, and to do that, it's very simple. All you really need to do here is just call it stock. It's very good stock play, and against man-to-man coverage is probably the toughest one that it has to face. So if they went to man coverage, though, what you're going to see here is this route to Darren McFadden is actually going to do some decent work. You just want to bullet pass it, no pass lead at all, just a simple bullet pass, and it's going to match him up one-on-one with a linebacker. Okay, from there, there's really not a whole lot else you can really do if they call man-to-man. Of course, your tight end route, if he has good route running, you see it's just a quick out, and he will do a decent job. One of the things that I've started doing, and this is mainly just because this out route doesn't do a whole lot for the offense, right, is I've started to place Cole Beasley on a hitch route, and I've started to smart route that route so it goes 10 yards. And what you'll find is, against two-man under, it's actually a really good option. So here we're going to call two-man under, and you're going to see that it's an unbumpable pass, and you want to hold left trigger. And you're going to see that it's going to, or L2 on PlayStation, and you're going to see that it's able to easily beat man-to-man. And it's very consistent as well. So I want to show this one more time. And what we're really keying in on is Cole Beasley here on this smart route, a hitch route. And what you're going to see is, is able to beat that cover two zone. Now, the only issue with that is that when we go into zone coverages and we do this, so for example, if they're just running a cover three, right? So we're just going to set it up the same way, and what you're going to see is they're going to be in very kind of interesting spots, to say the least. So what I like to use as a rule of thumb is if they are kind of matched up right over top of Cole Beasley. So for example, if they're in press coverage alignment, then that's when I'm going to say, okay, I want to make sure that Cole Beasley is on that smart route of hit trap, because normally against that it's going to be cover two. And as you can see, against just a standard cover two, Jason Witten's curl, it actually turns it into a nice little underneath curl route. So here they're running cover two, and Jason Witten's going to hitch up here very shallow as a nice option for you. So it's still going to work out very well. However, if they're going to cover three coverage, you want to leave Cole Beasley on his little out route, because what that's going to do is it's going to allow you to hit Jason Witten. Okay, so those are a couple basic principles for this play. The slant flat combo is actually very effective against cover three as well. So what you want to do here is if you see that it's cover three, you can just hit the slant route as he's coming over the middle of the field. Now, normally the way that you tell it's cover three is that one of the safeties are going to rotate to the middle of the field. So what you'll see here is that Stewart, this left side safety, rotates to the middle of the field. I know that it's cover three, and I know I have that slant flat read. Okay, so those are some basic concepts for this. And of course, you have Dez Bryant on this deep vertical route in case they, you know, try to really get aggressive and go cover zero without safe. If they don't have safety help over the top, you want to try to get that route into Dez Bryant. There we get intercepted. But normally, it's a pretty safe read. Especially if you have a good one-on-one target out there. Okay, so that's the stick play. We don't use it a ton. The mid-draw, one of the reasons I actually like this is because you can actually slide protect to the right. And when you slide protect to the right, it makes the mid-draw very effective as kind of like an inside type of run. It's really a change of pace run more so than anything. And one of the things it's really good for is if they're blitzing. So, for example, like if he's setting up some pressure, right, and we all know this is some basic pressure from the dime, right? Well, if you slide protect to the right, this mid-draw becomes a decent little option against that blitz, as you can see here. Okay, so that's the mid-draw, but the key plays that we're going to be utilizing are the play-action wide receiver in and the four verticals. Now, these are kind of our base shot plays. So for example, especially against baseline cover two, right? But also against cover three. So really zone coverage. If you're, and this is kind of what I like to kind of catchphrase as a zone base offensive formation, right? If we're facing a lot of zone coverage, we'll typically go into this formation because it gives us a lot of different things that we can do to beat the zone coverage. It's not quite as effective against man to man, but against zone it is very effective. So anywho, without further ado, so we're going to get into four verticals and then kind of the crowning jewel is PA wide receiver in. All right, so whenever I'm running four verticals, okay, there's a couple of keys to this. Now, the first one is the idea that we need to be able to at least recognize that most guys are going to user the middle linebacker when facing this formation, and they're going to key in on four verticals. That's pretty self-explanatory, and we all understand that. Now, here's a little concept that I've actually been doing, and I've had a surprising amount of success with it. What you want to do here, if you put Williams on basically just a standard hitch route, and then you bring Beasley across the formation, what you'll see is his little vertical route now turns into a corner route, and against cover two coverage, it gives him a one-on-one with the safety, which is normally a decent option because safeties don't have great coverage. And I've actually had a lot of success with that read. Another thing that I've been doing is using Dez Bryant as kind of the motion guy, if you will. And so bringing him across the formation and doing basically the same thing. And what you're going to see is he's going to kind of shoot up into the seams. And so what it really becomes is a four vertical side overloaded to the left side. Now, you can work with that a little bit. Another one that you can even try is to bring Witten across, and you'll see that if you bring a Witten across the formation like this, you now have a really interesting corner route that has a lot of things that it can do for you. Now, the cool part with bringing Witten across is you can create basic zone floods. It's always good to at least experiment with some of the options that you have available to you. Here we have a nice little base zone flood that we can do to hit Jason Witten in kind of this tender area of zone coverage. But even more than that, they're not going to be expecting this route. I'm telling you, I've never seen someone run this, ever. I've never seen anyone motion the tight end over and then use that as a man-beating route. Okay, so just know that going into it. So it is an option, but it's not something we do a ton. We do run it the base way. Now, what this basically means here in a nutshell is that cover three coverage, for example, you're going to have normally pretty good success with hitting Cole Beasley's route. So if they go cover three coverage normally, and you'll see just as common with anything, this route does a good job. And ignore Tony Romo's terrible throw there, and you'll be able to easily see that this is a really good little route here. Now the key is trying to figure out what makes this route so good so that you can keep that portion of the play and then change the other portion. So one of the ways that we like to do that is we like to take Dez Bryant and put him on a smoke screen. Basically what this is going to do is it's really just going to kind of get him out of the play, and we're going to try to see if Cole Beasley still gets that same opening deep. And as you see, he does. For the most part, we still get the same concept, right? We get the free safety forced with a decision that he has to make, based on that. And it really is this route combination with the deep post, deep vertical. Here, we'll show it to you again. And here you see the safety this time. He chooses, and again, ignore Tony Romo's awful throws. We'll try to get you a team tomorrow that has better throwing abilities. So then now what we want to see here happens if we put Dez Bryant on a drag pattern, a crossing route. So we go cover three, we got Bryant on the crossing pattern, and what you'll see here is the same kind of thing. Cole Beasley, especially with a guy with good speed, is going to outrun the corner deep, okay? So that's what we're seeing here. That's the constant theme. No matter what we put Dez Bryant on, right, it still works the same way. So what I like to do in that kind of realm is I like to kind of put Dez Bryant on some kind of route that I feel confident is going to beat man-to-man, right? Because normally the vulnerability is that if you go man-to-man against verticals and you use the tight end, then you kind of have, you know, a little bit of a weakness. And so we need to find something that we can do with Dez Bryant that's going to beat man-to-man. So what I like to do is I like to put him on a drag pattern, a crossing route. Now, this crossing pattern is not going to be 100% effective, but it is going to be very consistent for the most part, especially if you have a good wide receiver. Normally, it does good. Sometimes you may have to touch pass it, but it is basically a check down read, right? Now, the problem is we have two outside receivers that we are free to do anything with, right? Terrence Williams and Dez Bryant, but none of the hot routes this season do a really good job of beating man, except this one. The comeback route to Dez Bryant becomes a very good and interesting option for many reasons, but the first one is that we can motion Dez Bryant to the inside. Now, when you face man-to-man and you motion the receiver to the inside a couple steps here, you're going to see that when he comes back out, when he breaks, he's going to get open. As you can see here, very clear, and, well, of course, he that time his guy plays him, but normally this comeback route normally will do a good job against man-to-man specifically, and especially when he cuts to the outside. So here, and again, you can actually high pass lead this, and here we messed up there, but we'll show you this. And we'll show it to you hopefully in a game when you see the sample game. We'll run this a couple times. But basically, you know, we can't even get time in the pocket. Von Miller is just freaking ridiculous. Forgot to sub in the bad players so that I could have time to show you all the routes. See, there's the snapback, and that's what you're looking for. Now, you do see some kind of issues here, as you're seeing with him and Cole Beasley. One way to avoid that is to kind of bring him in all the way in here, right? So then he's definitely getting out there. You know, that's what you're looking for here. So we'll show you this against man, because that was zone. Sorry about that. So they go press man, you know, traditional coverage, right? Bring him on that motion, and he comes out, and you see this is what you're going to get. And, well, that was stupid stick. Sorry, I'm having so many mental breakdowns right here on national internet. Sorry about that. So here, we finally get into the right play call. So this is what we want, right? And we'll just clear everything out. So I just want to show you this right to Bryant. Just bring him all the way into motion here. It's going to put him on an inside comeback route. Now, you see Talib plays it really well, so that's something that definitely does impact, you know, whether we want to run this or not. If you get good with the comeback route, it actually becomes a very good route for this play. But right now, like I said, I'm not hitting it. And so if you're not feel comfortable with it, then you might take Dez Bryant, and what you can do with him, it's just a basic crossing pattern, whether it be a drag or a slant. Just motion him in a little bit here. It's going to get him free release. And you can actually playmaker him open here, as you can see underneath, if worst comes to worst and, you know, they use her that top seam route. Another route that you can put Dez Bryant on is something as simple as an in route. This season I'm noticing that a lot of people are abandoning this, but a simple in route here, motion snapped. What it's going to do, you see how that guy is jumping to the inside? If you playmaker him back outside, it now becomes a good option. Now, what that tells me in my head is that a good route to use would be a zig route. Okay, so we're going to show you the zig route now. And what you'll find is the zig route actually does a really decent job. A lot of people don't use this, but basically just a little motion in, zip, little whip route to the outside here. Normally, he'll get pretty good separation. And normally, he'll actually get good separation on his initial cut. And we'll look at this here. Just kind of a quick throw, as you can see that. And that's a snap throw, really, is pretty much what it is. Now, you don't want to force this again. You know, again, you know, maybe a couple times hitting them with this, and they'll get out of man. Normally, though, you'll see, and it's really all about getting him that inside position. And here we weren't. Kayvon Webster gets on it. Dude, the Broncos secondary is legit. They've got debt. Got a lot of good players. So the zig route is an option. And I'm finding that it's really more of an option than I ever really realized. Even though here, we're not doing great, it's a route running issue. And if you don't win the route running, you can high pass lead this threw it to the wrong guy. You can actually high pass lead the route and make it an aggressive catch battle. And we all know that Dez Bryant's probably going to win that, right? So what you'll see here is if, say, okay, he just wins right on that outside. So I'm going to high pass lead that, and you can see that it becomes more of an aggressive catch battle where only your receiver can get it. And that's really what we're looking at. When we're looking at this. Now, I know that this is kind of a stretch. And you can even, if you motion him all the way to the inside, you can see it's still the same thing, right? But that high pass lead makes it an aggressive catch issue. And as you can see here, Dez Bryant's going to make his aggressive catches, as you can see. Another thing that I wanted to go over on the crossing pattern. It really, a lot of the ability to beat man-to-man coverage this year depends on your leverage, right? So if we have an inside breaking pattern, we want to give him inside positioning. So one of the ways we do that is by motioning him all the way in here. And then once you get him in here, you can playmaker him back to the outside if you want. You can do a lot of things with him. Okay, so those are a couple options. Another thing is, again, just a simple out route or a simple in route. And what you want to do is, again, use the leverage. But here, just a little motion snap out route, and as you can see, that becomes something that's very good. Motion snapped out routes are very good this season. For some reason, hitch routes and in routes and all that stuff, motioned is not quite as effective. But here, we'll show you, if we just put Dez Bryant on a little out route here, and we just bring him inside a little bit and then motion snap him to the outside, You see, he's going to get that outside positioning. We can use a nice rack catch to get him the football. Okay, so you can kind of see that there. That's the basic premise. And I know it took us a little bit to get there, but I wanted to show you kind of the process I do go through when developing these things. And the cool part about this out route to Dez Bryant is that it's a pretty simple little read. You want to make sure that you don't get him muddied up. Basically, the one thing you're going to do to mess this up is you're going to snap him a little bit too late or a little bit too quick. And really, it's just, you know, you want to snap him right there. And as you can see, you get that natural pick and rub, and you get the opportunity. Now, the key to throwing this route real quickly is you don't want to throw it shallow, because if you throw it shallow, it has the potential to get undercut and taken back for six. What you want to do is high pass lead it so it goes out of bounds. In that way, even if it's a dicey scenario, as you saw right there, the worst thing that's going to happen is an incomplete pass, right? You want to throw the football where only your receiver can get it, and as you can see here, this makes this a really good option. Okay, that's what makes this an option, is because number one, it's consistently pretty solid compared to most things against guys with superior man coverage this season. Again, if you have route running out there, it's going to be really effective. Dez Bryant just doesn't have the greatest route running, but as you can see, it becomes a nice little back shoulder type of thing. All right, so one other thing I wanted to show you is just a standard comeback route. So if I didn't motion Dez Bryant, I just left him on this comeback route to the outside. What you'll actually see is it's not too shabby. As you can see, just a back shoulder kind of thing. No pass lead, just possession catch it. So you have all of those options at your disposal. Now what I like to do with this play is I like to take Terrence Williams here. I like to put him either on a comeback route or a smoke screen. Basically, this means if they go zone coverage, for example, if they go to a cover three buzz, right, this comeback route to Terrence Williams is going to snap back. Now, unfortunately, they're going to play it, but what that's going to do is it's going to leave some things open over the top. If they go man-to-man isolated, then I have a one-on-one, basically, and it's really just route. It's a route running issue. And so here he snaps back, and you see I get intercepted because Chris Harris has higher man coverage than Terrence Williams. So it really does become a matchup issue on this left side. And that's just one of those things that you just have to recognize. You know, do I have the matchup advantage? Do I not? That's what you're wanting to look for here. And then, you also want to have a check down where you don't need the matchup advantage, and that's to Dez Bryant. And basically what you're doing with Dez Bryant's route is you're creating natural pick and rubs, and what this does, as you can see here, there he gets that separation. That's what we're wanting. And you may have to motion him in a little bit more, but I want to show you this in instant replay because this is really critical to the breakdown. So when we bring Dez Bryant to the inside, right, and if they are in man, normally you won't even be calling this if they're in man, but what you see here is he's going to take that false step. As you see, he takes that planted step to the inside. Because why? He's having to overcompensate because Dez Bryant has that inside leverage, and then he's going to cut outside quickly for a nice little quick out. That's what we're looking at here. So let's see if we can replicate that one more time for you and show you what we're talking about, because that was a really good example. So you bring him in here, kind of snap him right around in this area, and you see that when he cuts to the outside, he's going to get that. And again, worst case scenario, you high pass lead that, and there's no possible way that the opponent's going to be able to get his hands on that ball. Now, he may tackle you and get a catch-tackle animation where you may drop it, but you're not going to throw interceptions, right? So that's the key. And you see, this is it becomes a really good little route here. Even if he gets his hands on it, he's not going to intercept it. And that's what we're looking at here, safe passing patterns that, you know, really do a decent job beating most guys in man coverage. And it's this high pass lead type of thing. As you can see, Dez Bryant consistently brings that in. Now, we want to show you this against cover three. So the key to the verticals is its ability to be cover two and its ability to be cover three. So here's that setup. And again, you can put these guys on the left and whatever you really want. The key is these middle routes, right? So we bring Dez Bryant in, snap him right around here, and you're going to see that this cover three read, it becomes a speed battle. Right, And unfortunately for most guys, you're going to win that because you have a step on them, basically. So we'll show you this again. And you'll see here you get a step. We can't even show you these stupid. For some reason, they make this game so weird in the sense that the pocket really collapses on you. And I know it's real life, right? I know it's to imitate real life, but what I'm saying is it like makes you take really bad backwards. Look at that. Look at that, like, 2-second pressure. And I'm just trying to teach you guys a route concept here. Anyway, enough complaining. Let's just execute here. So bring him in. And you see that Cole Beasley still's got that seam. He still has the seam. There he drops the ball, but he still has the seam. Now, we're going to block the running back just to give us some time here. So here's cover three. And now what you're going to see is it's a one-on-one, right? It's a one-on-one, deep. Now, you actually have a step, but Cole Beasley's so freaking slow, right? If you're in MUT, you can have a little bit of a faster guy there. It's going to work out for you more. Now, if you want to make sure he's clearly open, right? You want that clean throw. Put Brian on this fade route. Now, what you can do with this one is I'm pretty sure that you can motion him to the inside, and it's still going to work properly. As you see here, and then you've got that void to either that safety has to choose between Witten or between Beasley. He has to pick one of those two players that he's going to take and defend himself. So here you see it again. Here's cover three. This time he takes Witten. We can't freaking get the pass off because of stupid edge rush. You know what? Let's try and do this. Quarterback contain rushes. And then we put Brian on his route and just motion him in a little bit. You'll see here Cole Beasley comes right up that seam. Okay, that's what we're looking to get there. I know that so here it is. So four verticals, you take Bryant, you've got him on the fade route. Now you just give him a little motion here, and you're gonna see, right, it still works. And here we have to go to Witten, but you see the idea. Now, that is a lot of build-up to this because it gives you a lot of different options. The first thing you can do with this is you can run Bryant on a little quick out. Now, if they go into cover two, that makes it a little bit dicey because it's you're playing a one-on-one battle, right? So, if you leave Des Bryant on his standard route, then it changes how you're going to be able to beat man, because you can't use three people to beat man now. It's more of a one-person show. Your running back has to beat man-to-man. And then on the outside, it's going to be a matchup issue. And I want to show you this, too. So if they're in cover three and he's on a comeback route, I want to show you that he still pulls that safety, as you can see here. The safety on the left and the corner on the left, they're still pulled down. That's actually a really big and really important thing. The only thing that really matters is if you take Bryant and motion him, right? And that's kind of unfortunate because it does limit you a little bit in what you can do. As you see here, that safety takes that false step. Man, Romo sucks in this game. Anyway, so that's the basic principles of the four verticals. Now, the key to four verticals in zone coverage, specifically zone coverage, right? When you're facing, basically you want to look at the safeties, and if the safety comes down onto R1, normally X is going to become wide open here. So the safety is going to come down, and here you'll see, and it really is just kind of a read, as you can see there. They do stay deep occasionally, but what it becomes is a little bit more than just a read. So I'm looking here, and you'll see here he just abandons R1, right? He takes a false step and abandons R1. Now I want to show you this flip. So I want to show you the other safety playing the deep vertical, and then the strong side safety playing the deep vertical, the backside safety playing the hook. All right, so this is it. Let me set it up, and you'll see now there's a lot more likelihood that Witten's going to get open than Cole Beasley. So that's really your read. If the safety comes down into your zone, right, what you're basically reading is play side safety, right? So, for example, if they go cover two, now this is a coverage where both safeties go vertical, right? So your play side safety here is Jimmy Ward or TJ Ward, and he's going to go vertical up the seam. Now, when play side safeties go vertical, that means that's kind of your key here to tell you, and we don't get a good look there, but basically it's your key to say, look away from the vertical route because the safety's flowing upfield with it. What you want to do now is get to your check down reads, whether it be to Darren McFadden or Terrence Williams or Witten, right? Because Williams is going to be on a comeback route, and then McFadden's on a little check down, little flat route, as you can see here. Now, the one issue I'm finding, and this is why I actually think cover two is a really, really strong defense to run this season, is that the four verticals, for me, has some struggle against cover two. And the more that I look into it, the best way I know to beat it is Bryant's route here is a kind of a fade, right? But more so a streak. So if he's on a streak, you're going to see that it's going the same place. If he's on a fade, you see that he's going to fade to the sideline. Now, this is a big deal because it's, as you see down the seam, it actually creates a lot of different spacing techniques. So I want to show you this in a replay, and we'll go and look at it after the snap. But just showing you the concept here. And that's exactly what I wanted to show you. So this is a big change to your basic verticals route. And I want to show you why this is so important. So what's going to happen when you put Dez Bryant on this fade route is his safety now has to pick who he's going to follow up the seam. And what you'll see here is the safety is going to normally choosing this middle post deep vertical streak route. Why? Because this corner has the deep responsibility because this guy is on a vertical. And what they would leave open then would be this underneath flat. But here, the underneath guy is going to hold that corner. You see the corners break here. And you see this guy's breaking here. The linebackers over the middle are covering Witten. And at this point, you now have a window, a much larger window, okay, than you normally would have. It becomes, you know, probably a good 6 to 7 yard window that you can deliver this ball to Dez Bryant. Now I want to show you what happens if you just leave Dez Bryant on his standard route. So here's cover two, Dez Bryant's on a standard route. And here what you'll see, and this is important. Now I know he took a sack, but you can still see it in the coverage. So in the all 22 footage here, we take a look at this. And what you'll see here is TJ Ward's back paddling, right? He still breaks here, right? He still breaks here on this streak, right? But look at how close he is to Dez Bryant. If I throw to Dez Bryant here, he can easily break on this ball, right? And you see there, I have to take the sack because there's nobody open, right? Now, this is probably what a lot of you are seeing when you see these cover two defenses. Well, what I'm proposing is if you put him on a fade route, it changes the spacing. And now, when he's on this fade route, he has to pick. He being TJ Ward, right? And again, Romo can't get the ball there for some reason. But basically, and what of course I like to do is motion McFadden here to the right. And why is because it's going to really help you against cover two. So this is cover two defense. And now Bryant's on the fade route. And now TJ Ward, and again, I don't know why Romo's having such a hard time throwing the freaking ball. But it basically boils down to this. Snap the ball, step up in the pocket, deliver a strike to Dez. That's what you're looking at. Because TJ Ward is going to be forced to come inside. And for some reason, Romo's literally like just sucking. And there it is. So, and of course, he can't even get in the ball. I've never seen this before. Like, I feel like Romo has always been pretty accurate for me in Madden. Today, he's just literally all over the place. Right there. That's what you want. Okay? So here's what happens. And this is what, I don't think we even put him on the fade that time. Let's see if we can give you a good example here. With the MUT quarterbacks, you're going to have a lot better of a time. But basically, there's a key little window where that safety, what you're waiting for is the safety to turn his hips and to commit. When he turns his hips, that means he's committing. And so what you'll see here from the safety, as we look at it from Tony Romo's perspective now, and we'll raise it up a little bit so you can see a little better. But basically, we drop back. We see that McFadden is open here. We also, you know, kind of could maybe hit the route to Beasley, but the safety is going to have the opportunity to close on him. But you see here, the safety turns his hips to the inside there, and he no longer has a play on Dez Bryant, as you can see here. Dez Bryant now breaks away, and we're able to have that window to throw him the ball. So that's the key, right? And that's a lot of keys, you know, but it is the, you know, that is what you're looking for. Now, I want to show you one other thing that I've actually thought I could do, and it really works. So use the PA wide receiver in play to do this, and it's for cover two, specifically cover two. You don't want to do this against anything else. But anyway, what you do here is you're going to take Cole Beasley's route, and you're going to put him on a fade route. And then you're going to take Jason Witten's route, you're going to put him on a streak. And then you're going to take McFadden, and you could put him on a little swing route to the right, you could put him on a wheel route to the right, it doesn't really matter. But they go cover two here. Now what we're looking to do, our target of choice is Cole Beasley. So we'll see if this works. Now it doesn't work for us, so I can't show it to you. Sorry. Didn't work right. So back to four verticals. Let me show you this. Basically, the idea here is that Cole Beasley is going to, and you want to give Brian a little motion. So if I give Brian a little motion here, and you could just use, I mean, you can hit Dez as well, as you see there. So it is, you don't have enough vertical routes, I guess. Anyway, go back to four verticals for a second. Now, another thing is they're going to run two men under, right? So that's pretty much a guarantee. Well, when you motion McFadden over here to this side, it actually does a decent job at beating man-to-man. So just a little quick out. He has a little stutter step and go. And normally you're going to have pretty good success with that route beating man coverage, especially when you motion it. The main reason is because it's going to give him a free release from the line of scrimmage. So he just gets through it quick and goes. See, even against zone, you can hit it. Okay. Now, cover three. So back to cover three for a moment. And again, the only thing you do is you have Brian on that fade route. And then you could put Williams on a, you can put him on a comeback. You could even put him on a drag if you wanted to. But normally he's on a comeback for me. Right, so you have your little quick outs, right?
Now,
what do you do whenever they are blitzing you from cover three? Well, this is what I like to do. I like to have Williams here on a smoke screen, and he's actually my first read. And what happens is if they're sending pressure, which oftentimes this is the best way to stop this read, that means that there's no flat zone. Right, that means that there's no flat zone on the left side of the field, or whatever side they're blitzing from, right? So now I have basically the equivalent of what two flat routes are. So here I just hit Williams, and of course he flips around. But you see the idea here, hopefully. You have the smoke screen, and what it does is it just provides you a check down read, right? And again, your option route or this little out route will do a good job against man-to-man. Another route that's going to do a good job against man-to-man, if they leave it open, is this tight end crossing pattern. again, you want to get a tight end with good route running, of course. It's and you know you want to play the matchup game, but again, that's what you're looking for. Okay, so now I want to get into baseline cover two. So this is why you're actually going to go to this formation in the first place, is baseline cover two. Now, what baseline cover two is going to give you access to is a cover two defense.
Essentially a cover two.
Gosh, dang, I'm yawning. Essentially a cover two defense that is very susceptible to this route right here to McFadden. So if we put McFadden on the streak route, what you're going to find is against the cover two defense, this becomes a very interesting option. We'll put McFadden on a streak and we'll put Bryant on a fade. And what you'll see is against cover two, actually, yeah, we'll do it like that. But against cover two, what normally occurs is this route to Cole Beasley opens up. And the reason it opens up is because the deep blue zone has to worry about the route to Bryant still. So we'll show you this again. Now, the problem is quick reads against cover two don't really exist anymore. And see here, so this is another example, and hopefully we can show it to you in practice in instant replay here. So this is an example of a read where the safety turns his hips, but he turns them to Des Bryant. Now this will happen. Normally it will actually happen against the baseline cover two, but let me get back to Romo's footage here and give you some all 22 film. So basically we're reading that high safety to see where it goes, because we identify that it's cover two from the get, right? And we acknowledge that we have the check down read here to McFadden. But what we see is that the safety turns his hips to that outside, and we're able to have that nice window to go deep to Cole Beasley, as you can see there. So that's really what we're getting after. If they go man to man, again, this is what I want to stress with you guys. If they go man to man, you actually have some interesting dynamics that are going to occur with safeties, and it's going to allow you the chance for a one-on-one opportunity to the tight end and also to the other guys. So that's what we're looking at. Another thing that I've actually experimented with a little bit is putting the tight end on a basic streak, and what you'll find is that against cover two, it does a really good job because it sends that tight end vertical much deeper than the post route. And what you'll see oftentimes is the ability to kind of sneak it in with a high pass lead, something like that. But you can experiment with that on your own. All right, so the last play I want to talk about today is PA wide receiver in. And this is a really good play for a number of reasons. But the first one is because it's going to help you beat zone coverage. So if they, and specifically, cover two or cover three. So we'll go cover two first. And what we're just going to do is we're going to put Jason Witten on a streak route. And then we want to block our halfback. The reason we want to block our halfback is because it's going to require a lot of time. So I like to block my halfback and slide my line to the right. And what you're going to see here is that against the cover two, we're going to be able to hit this. And Tony Romo can't freaking throw the ball. I wonder if Matt Castle's in or something. Like, this is Romo, and he's making these awful throws. But anyway, here we're going to see it. And against cover two, you're going to step up in, or this was cover three, sorry. But you'll have this deep post route to Dez. Assuming that Harris doesn't get in the way. I don't know what's going on right now with our rosters. But basically, send him deep. Oh, and you can put McFadden on an option route. If you put McFadden on an option route, again, you motion him to the right. And cover two. Here you'll see he turns his hips. Same kind of scenario. Safety turns his hips. That's where we get it. Now cover three. Cover three, what you're going to look to do here is you're going to look to hit. We don't even have a freaking time in the pocket. Basically, it's going to be a read. The safety's going to pick. He's normally going to pick Jason Witten's route. He's going to stay vertical with it. But basically, it's just a read on the safety. Here, this is cover two. And you can kind of fit that in as you see there. But what if they go cover three, right? So, over. Step up in the pocket here. Gosh, dang it, man. The pressure. Seriously, I've got to freaking fix that for the next couple videos in the series, because we can't have this. Anyway, so here it is. And that's your setup. And they go... And what you'll find is that basically they're going to get in voids in those deep zones is really what's going to happen. There's going to be a lot of confusion in the deep blue zone area. Normally you're going to be able to hit... normally you're going to be able to hit Witten or Des Bryant. Those are the two main ones that will come open. But it's basically just they're going to cause a lot of voids here. And as you see, there's that false step, and then it's going to give you a one-on-one with your tight end. Okay, so if you have a fast tight end, this becomes a really good option for you. But again, you know, it's pretty simple. There you see it, and there that tight end gets that step. Okay, so it is kind of hard to show in practice mode, just because, like, Jason Witten, I picked a really bad team to show this with you guys today, because... For some reason, Romo can't even get the ball down the field. Normally, he has no issues with that, because I'll look into that after this game. But here it is, and if they give you time in the pocket, you're going to basically, your tight end is going to be wide open deep down the field. Now, we're having some issues because Romo can't get the ball to him, but normally, he'll be fine. And there you see that false step that the safety takes. We'll show you that in instant replay, and then we'll let you guys go for the day. Guys, do me a favor. If you like this series, what we're doing, just subscribe if you haven't already, guys. If you like today's video and you would like to see more content, then just subscribe. And all I ask is that, again, if you're a subscriber, then you just simply share this video. But anyway, here's what you're going to see. So, basically, what we're looking to do here is this guy right here is the issue, and we want to get him to take a false step. So what you'll see here is that when this post route comes underneath, he's going to take a false step down, right? So we're just going to run in here, and there's the false step. You see that? There's he's meant to make up his mind, and that gives Witten time to get a step on him. You see at this point, Witten has him, right? He has a step on him, and so a high pass lead is going to mean for a wrap catch downfield. That's what we're looking to get, okay? Now, in MUT, you're going to be able to put a wide receiver there because you can put him there on your depth chart. Another key feature of MUT is that you're going to be able to get guys there that have like 90 speed, 97 speed kind of thing. Witten doesn't have that, unfortunately. Here he doesn't take the false step. That leaves a one-on-one for Dez, basically, is what we're looking at. So that's a... PA halfback will. I wanted to show. Kind of wanted to show one other thing. So, if you're going up against man a lot and you have this play at your disposal, it's a really good man beater for several reasons. But the biggest one is because you can get natural picks and rubs. So, if you put your far right receiver on a drag, normally I'll put Witten on a streak and then I'll take McFadden and throw him on a wheel. And this is a really good little setup here. To be able to beat some man-to-man, you see Des Bryant's going to get open on his crossing pattern. So, just some extra things you can do. But that concludes the shotgun wide trips halfback breakdown. If you have any questions or would like to talk with me a little further about some of the plays discussed in today's video, please let me know. We have several more coming. I wanted to show this one next in the sequence because it's very similar to the shotgun bunch. That's really why. So, this is not one of the formations we run a ton of. We do run it some, and I did want to show it to you guys. These are some basic concepts from it. So it's a very effective formation this season, especially at zone defense. So if you're having a lot of zone come up, you can definitely use this shotgun wide trips halfback week setup here. So anyways, guys, we'll be back tomorrow. We'll show you another formation. I think we're talking about one. I think we're talking about a man beating. So, but anyways, guys, be sure to come back tomorrow. And guys, I do.